Welcome to the Kelly File, everyone. I'm Megyn Kelly. Breaking tonight, polls are moving, the race is changing, and more than a dozen Republican candidates are trying to make themselves heard with a little more than 1 week left till the debate. That could change everything. And we're the gateway. We, the questioners, are the gateway. We at Fox and CNN and everybody else who gets a chance to actually moderate a presidential debate with these guys. I mean, these guys, they deserve to face tough questioning. As Chris says, and I agree, they want George Washington's job, and they better earn it. They better show the American people they're worthy of it. A lot of folks assumed Donald Trump would flame out by now. They have been proven wrong. Now, wait.
Here, we got to get to this, because this is just breaking on the Daily Beast. The headline is, ex-wife, Donald Trump made me feel violated during sex. Ivana Trump once accused the real estate tycoon of, quote, rape. Somebody who speaks for Donald Trump has come out and denied it as well, and added that legally, he says, you cannot rape your spouse.
Here's the one thing you probably know about me. I have a big mouth.
Roger, you have Megyn on line one.
Megyn?
Morning, Roger.
What'd you do to piss off Trump?
We did a segment on recent coverage of his ex-wife's rape claim.
You're giving that oxygen before the first goddamn debate?
Roger, we had a full screen of Ivana's recantation, which is soft.
She accused him during a divorce.
Well, his lawyer, Michael Cohen, claims he can't rape his spouse. Pissed me off.
Great. The future Fox News is now a goddamn feminist.
No, I'm not a feminist. I'm a lawyer.
We need him.
Clean this up. Now.
Unfortunately, when it comes to politicians and the media, Roger Ailes knows a shit. Appointed head of the Fox News Channel by media mogul Rupert Murdoch, Roger transformed cable news, pushing Fox to the forefront. Years before, to get Nixon elected, he created the modern town hall debate. To get Reagan elected, he made him address the elephant in the room.
I will not make age an issue of this campaign. I am not going to exploit my opponent's youth and inexperience.
To get George H.W. Bush elected, somebody did the Willie Horton ads. Roger denies it was him. A lot.
I have been astounded at the number of Americans who are fine with our country moving in a socialist direction.
Here we go.
Their views on capitalism are quite alarming.
News is like a ship. You take your hands off the wheel and it pulls hard to the left. Hey, look at this. James Murdoch. Tell me those lips haven't sucked cock. This is what nepotism gets you.
Roger rules Fox from behind these doors on the second floor. When employees say the second floor, they mean Roger. Or the many VPs paid to enact his will without qualms or questions. Now, I know what some of you are thinking, and no, Roger does not tell us what to say on air. He doesn't have to.
Love that dress, Megyn.
Thank you.
No, really. I love it.
He's not horny. He's just ambitious. Roger is always watching.
The Eagles postponed their appearance because co-founder Glenn Frey is too ill to travel. In a statement, the band announced...
Morons.
The phone in his office connects directly to the control room, which is down on the first floor.
Yes, sir?
Fucking idiot! That's not Glenn Frey, it's Don Henley!
Dump the B-roll.
Dump.
Back to anchor. That's not Glenn Frey, that's Don fucking Henley.
Oh, shoot.
What the fuck, Kayla?
I'm sorry, I don't know secular music.
The Eagles?
Only the biggest band of the 70s.
When my mom was a toddler.
They all look the same, they dress old.
Down in the basement is the Fox newsroom. All our shows have crews who work in these pods. This is my staff. Hey, guys.
Hey.
We're below the city, so it smells like mold. But there hasn't been a rat sighting in 4 months.
Yeah.
The anchors and their key producers have base camps here on 17 and 18, often decorated with viewer art. And everyone in this building, even Roger, answers to 8. The 8th floor is home to CEO Rupert Murdoch and his sons. This is the power. Behind the power. The actual studios are scattered around the building. Most anchor and show offices are here. Above are Fox Business, Radio, New York Post, and the Wall Street Journal. Most of the American conservative establishment in one building.